90% of all people with diabetes in the United States and worldwide have type 2 diabetes, and this is driven in large part by the epidemic of obesity. Our laboratories in the section on obesity and hormone action focus on these two important aspects of the basic causes driving this epidemic of type 2 diabetes. First, what causes obesity, and what can we do about obesity? Secondly, how does obesity alter the action of hormones like insulin so that the body no longer responds normally to the insulin that's secreted by the pancreas? This is a state we call insulin resistance. In people who have insulin resistance, the islets continue to make insulin, but the tissues of the body, like the liver, muscle, and fat, no longer respond to this hormone. And this is leading to the state of diabetes in most of these individuals. So we link these two areas in the section on obesity and hormone action by trying to understand, first, how does fat form? What causes it to accumulate in people with obesity? Why does it accumulate in certain areas of the body? Because we know that central obesity, that is obesity that's around your belly, is more likely to be linked to diabetes than peripheral obesity, say, carrying your weight in your hips and thighs. What causes fat to go to these different areas of the body, and how does this central accumulation of fat cause insulin resistance? Everyone is aware of the epidemic of obesity, which is the accumulation of white adipose tissue, that type of fat that accumulates under your skin and inside your body when you become overweight. But the body actually has more than one type of fat. It also has a second kind of fat called brown fat. Brown fat has been known to exist in animals and in newborn humans for many years, but it's been debated whether adult humans have brown fat, and if they do, would this brown fat be functionally important? While white fat stores energy, brown fat burns energy. In fact, it burns an awful lot of energy. As little as 2 ounces of brown fat, when fully stimulated, can burn up to 400 to 500 calories of energy a day. A few years ago, we became interested in this question of, could adult humans have brown fat, and why has it been missed for so many years? And we took advantage of a new technology that has been recently introduced for clinical purposes called PET CT scanning. Using this combination of techniques in collaboration with investigators at the Beth Israel Deaconess Hospital, we recognize the fact that adult humans do have brown fat. The reason it had been missed is it's not easily detectable in everybody, and it's not where we thought it would be. And so now we recognize that adult humans have brown fat, and that the activity of this brown fat varies depending on both their sex, the nature of their body weight, and even the body, even the temperature outdoors, which can affect the activity of brown fat. We're hoping to find new ways to increase the amount of brown fat and increase the activity of brown fat so that we might use this as a treatment or prevention for obesity.